Hello and welcome to this Hog 4 tutorial, which will look at the playing back of cues and some of the cue list options, as well as how to adjust the playback rate on the console. The playback bar is found at the bottom of the left-hand display. When empty, you can see numbers 1 to 10, and these correspond to the physical playback masters. We can move lists, scenes, and groups onto the playback masters. This tutorial will focus on lists, so first of all we need to open the list directory by either pressing list followed by open, or double pressing the list key. All of our cue lists are displayed in this directory and can be moved to the masters by pressing the list key followed by the number of that list, pressing move, and then the choose key of the master. When guard is selected, you can touch the list on the screen, then press move and the choose key. I have now moved several different lists to the playback bar to demonstrate how information is displayed. The list number and name is displayed at the top of each master. The current cue and its time is displayed on the second row. A released master, in other words, a master that has no cue currently running and therefore has no effect on playback, is shown by four dots at the top of the list. When a cue is running, the text turns green. The next cues to be played are displayed below, and the playback bar can be expanded to see more cues in each list. The master fader level is displayed at the bottom. Next to that are symbols which refer to any options selected for each list. In the case of masters 9 and 10, HTP. Each playback master has its own go, halt, back, and flash key, as well as a fader. There are also master playback controls, which control whichever is the chosen master. Only one master is chosen at a time, and the title in the playback bar turns blue. This master number is also displayed in the main toolbar. The rate of playback can be changed by holding down a choose key and adjusting the cue list rate, which affects cue timings, and the cue list effect rate, which changes the rate of any running effects on that master. By using the rate wheel on the Hog 4 console and also on Hog 4 PC, these two rates can be quickly overridden. Below the wheel is a rate button which toggles between playback rate, effect rate, and none, which disables the wheel. The restore button above returns the rate to that set in the cue list options. By default, only the chosen master is affected by the rate wheel. Multiple masters can be controlled at once by holding down the chosen master and pressing other choose keys. To release the selected masters function, press any choose key. Cue lists don't need to be assigned to masters to be played back. They can be run as virtual cue lists, either triggered by macros or controlled directly from the list directory. To play a cue, ensure that guard is turned off and click or press the list. The current cue is displayed here. To adjust the virtual fader level for this, press and hold the list and turn the fifth encoder wheel. By default, the console uses LTP, or latest takes precedent, for all parameters including intensity. Lists can be set to use HTP, or highest takes precedent, for intensity only. I've set up masters 7 through 10 to give a very basic example of the difference between these two rules of playback. Lists 7 and 9 have our solar spots recorded at 100%, and lists 8 and 10 have the same fixtures recorded at 50%. The only difference is that I have set lists 9 and 10 to work as HTP. When I press go on master 7, the solar spots go to 100%. By pressing go on master 8, they are released from master 7 and changed to the level which they were most recently given, which is 50%. By releasing the master, the fixtures go to zero. When I now bring the level for the HTP master 9 to full, the fixtures change to 100%. Pressing play on master 10 does not override this level. When I fade down master 9, the fixtures stay at 50%, as master 10 is now giving the fixtures their highest value. We can also use masters 7 and 8 to demonstrate the use of the assert and release keys. Once again, if I press go on master 8, the fixtures change to 50%. Pressing go on master 7 overrides this value and takes control of those fixtures, increasing them to 100%. To reassert the level of master 8, press the choose key for that master and press assert. To release the master, press Release. These keys can be used with masters that are not the currently chosen master. For example, Master 8 is currently chosen, but I can release Master 1 by holding down the Choose key and pressing Release. In doing this, Master 8 remains the chosen master. We will now take a look at a cue list window. These can be opened by either holding down the Open key and pressing the desired Choose key, or double pressing the Choose key. You can also double click in the playback bar. Here cues can easily be named or renumbered by either double clicking in a box or touching the box and pressing the Set key. Text comments can also be entered. The basic timing of cues can be changed here, and this will be covered in the next tutorial. When a cue list ends up with lots of point cues, as in my example here, it can be quickly renumbered by pressing this button. By selecting Follow Cue, as you play back the cues in your list, your current cue will remain central in the window as the list automatically scrolls down. When Follow Chosen is selected, the cue list window will change to display the list for whichever is currently the chosen master. Pressing the Options button gives you access to several different playback options. I shall only give a brief overview of these options in this tutorial, but there is more information about all of these in the HOG 4 manual, which can be opened on your system by pressing the Help button. The Priority section affects the LTP rule. On occasions, where the same fixtures are controlled in two different cue lists, you may wish one list to have a higher priority, meaning that the second list will have no effect over these fixtures until the higher list has been released. When Persist on Override is selected, a fixture will return to the level it was at in this cue list after a different cue list that had previously taken control of the fixture is released. Release on Other Go means that this cue list will automatically be released as soon as the Go command is given to any other cue list. The Properties section is where a cue list can be assigned to use the HTP rule for intensity. You can also tell the list to be a chase, which turns all the cues in the list into steps within that chase. Reset on Release means that whatever cue you are running when a list is released, when you next play that list, the first cue will be played. By pressing the Master and Main tabs, the actions of the playback buttons can be changed. In the next tutorial, we shall look at the recording of and use of palettes. Thank you for watching.